Hello everyone, thanks for clicking the link. In this video, I am going to talk about RODM. RODM, that is reconfigurable optical add-drop multiplexing configuration. So here I am going to cover about what are the benefits and why we need a RODM. And also I am going to cover why a single WSS RODM configuration called directional dependent. And how we can make that directional configuration to directionless configuration. For this, I am going to cover about WSS block architecture, like how a WSS works. So before going to RODM, we'll cover the legacy OADM configuration. OADM stands for optical add drop multiplexer. That means a site where we can add, drop and pass through the signal, and we'll understand what are the limitations we are getting in OADM configuration that are overcome using the RODM. So for illustration purpose, here I'm using a site which is a OADM site, and this site has east direction and west direction. That means a signal we can receive from east and pass through to west direction. And as this is a OADM, so we can add drop the traffic also. So for this, let's take east directions first. Here we have the amplifier from where we'll receive the signal from east, and we have a filter, that is a multiplexer, and a transponder. That is a normal WDM signal flow. If you want to know more about this, please watch my another video, that is on DWDM basic component and signal flow. Similar we have for the west direction. So here we'll receive the signal, it goes to amplifier, then it goes to filter, which will multiplex or demultiplex the signal, and signal will drop on transponder. And similar way, if we want to add the traffic, we'll add the traffic on the transponder, it goes to filter and then amplifier and goes out. And similar configuration for west direction also. Now in the past, to send a signal pass through, we are using the filter port. But this filter port has the specific wavelength port, like 191.0 terahertz, 192.0 terahertz, 193.0 terahertz. So based on the wavelength that we want to pass through, we'll connect the filter port of specific port like 192 with both the filter, and we'll connect with fiber and attenuator, and will just pass through the signal. Now if we add two more sites here, or direction, like north direction and south direction, so here also we use the same, like signal are coming from the north, if we want to drop, we can drop on transponder, and if you want to make a pass through, we can make a pass through also. And to send the signal from east direction to south direction, like now I want to send my signal from east to south, so we need to connect the both the filter of east and south with each other. For this, we'll again use the specific frequency or wavelength port. Like here we have the 194 terahertz, so we'll connect the fiber between these two ports, and our signal will pass through from east to south direction. But now imagine, after some time, if customer told now he want to send signal to north, not in south, means that is signal that is coming from east, he want to transmit in the north direction, means direction need to change. So what action we need to do? We need to visit the site, change the fiber from south filter to north filter. And similar, If customer want to change the wavelength, now he is using 194 terahertz. Now he want to change the wavelength to 193 terahertz. So we need to change the filter port also. So all this work involved site visit cost, and every time we need to do the manual work, and this is a time consuming activity, and there are chances of mistake while removing the patch code and connecting with another direction of WM filter card. So to overcome all this, we need a reconfigurable support, like where we can remotely change the direction or wavelength. That is why we move to RODM, that is reconfigurable optical add drop multiplexing configuration. For RODM, let's take the existing configuration. Like we have the east direction, we have the existing component, amplifier, filter, and transponder. Now to make this site as a RODM configuration site, we'll add one more component, that is WSS, that is wavelength selective switch. That is the main core of a RODM configuration. And WSS support cross connection that we can do now remotely, that make helpful this configuration as reconfigurable. And in market, as different manufacturing company has several type of WSS present, like we have 1x2, 1x9, 1x20, and these 2, 9 and 20 represent the number of the port of WSS. So in WSS, one port we have for signal input and output. That port we connect with amplifier. And we have one port where we can add drop the signal. So that port we connect with our multiplexer. There are more ports also available in WSS, like in 1x9 we have the 9 port. Rest of the port are used to connect with other WSS, which we'll cover later. For now, let's keep unconnected. Now here, signal will receive from each direction, goes to amplifier, then goes to WSS and filter and transponder. Similar way, we can add the signal on the transponder, filter, WSS and amplifier also. And same configuration will make for west direction also, where we have the amplifier, WSS, filter and transponder. And now to pass through the signal from east direction to west direction, we'll use the WSS port, that is normally called as pass through port. So we'll connect this port with both of the WSS, and this pass through port and rest of the WSS port has the capability to pass through all the wavelength together. Like if we have the 96 wavelength, so we can transmit all the 96 wavelength, we can easily pass through using a single port. Now we have no dependency on a filter specific port. So if we want to transmit two wavelength, we can easily pass through using on a single WSS pass through port. So we'll receive the signal from east and we can pass through to the west direction. Now let's make a two more direction on this site using the same configuration, where we have the amp, filter and WSS on north and similar on the south side. Now to make the signal pass through from east to south, we'll use the unconnected WSS port and we'll connect a fiber between. And same, this port also has the capability to pass through all the wavelength together. So now if we have a signal coming from east, we just need to make a cross connection with specific WSS and signal will pass through to another direction. And this fiber connectivity from one WSS to another, this is one time fiber work. We just need to make the cross connection. Now, if you want to change it to south, we'll just make a cross connection with the south WSS. If we want to resend into west, we just need to make a cross connection with west side of WSS. Similar way, we can connect rest of the WSS with each other. We can connect east with north, north with west, and west with south. And now we can transmit the signal in any direction, just making the cross connection from east to north also, from north to west also. And this is, we just need to make a cross connection that we can do remotely. That is why we call this is a reconfigurable add drop optical multiplexing configuration, ROADM configuration. So using ROADM, now we can make the changes in network quickly, and that is time saving, no site visit cost, and we can avoid the manual work every time because this is the one time fiber task. Same way, we can connect more direction of WSS also. Like if we have the 6 direction, 7 direction or 8 direction, we can connect the rest of the WSS port with each other. I hope till now it's clear. Now, take a look why we call direction dependent. Here, you can see signal coming from east is going out to south direction. Signal output of WSS. Similar, added signal, newly added signal is going via same signal output. So this question might be came in your mind, but it came in mind in my initial days of when I started working on ROADM. Why we can't signal through the pass through, like from the east signal, why we can't send the signal using the south WSS to north direction? And similar way, while adding the signal, why it's always going out from signal output, why we can't send it to east direction? This is because of WSS architecture, which make this configuration as direction dependent, as signal can go to specific direction only. To understand this, let's have a look on WSS block architecture. So for illustration purpose, we'll use this as a WSS block or a WSS card. In WSS, have a signal in output which normally connect with amplifier or other direction of add, drop the add or receive the signal. Okay. On in port, we receive the signal and then we'll split the signal into two. For this, I'm just sharing here, I'm using a splitter. Internally, one port of splitter goes to drop on filter. Like if we want to drop any signal, we can drop on specific port. And this dropping signal dropped on a filter card. Another port of splitter connect with WSS, that is inbuilt in WSS card we have. For pass-through signal, it goes from out of one of the WSS port going toward another WSS, and rest of the WSS port will connect with other WSS. So based on the connection, signal goes out to pass through or other signal WSS. Similar way to adding signal from other WSS, in WSS card, WSS receives the signal on input and it's sent to combiner. It combines all the incoming signal and send out to next combiner. And what's the use of next combiner here? If we want to add any signal on specific side from the filter, so that signal is received on input and combined with existing channel. And output will again go to next combiner. The use of this combiner, if we have any incoming signal from other pass-through port, like here we have the input that is connecting with this WSS combiner. So here it's combined all the channel together and signal goes out. Here you can look again, we receive the signal, it goes to screen, stroke the signal if you want to drop, and if you want to send it to another direction of WSS or pass through, it goes to WSS and signal goes out based on our cross connection. If we make it pass through, it goes to pass through port or another WSS port. Similar way, we receive the signal from other WSS, it goes to combiner and we'll add the signal from locally here. It goes to combiner and signal goes to next combiner. And from pass through direction also, we receive the signal. Here we again combine all the signal together and signal goes out. Okay. Here you will get adding an incoming signal is going out from signal out port only. That is why it's make it as direction dependent. I hope this is clear now why we call this is as a direction dependent. Now in the network, if you want to make existing direction dependent configuration to directionless configuration, so for this I am using the same architecture. I am not using the add drop filter and transponder here. I am just connecting the east and west using the pass through port of WSS. So to make it directionless, we'll use one more WSS. And the port of WSS will connect with each other. Like east direction WSS will connect with this new WSS port and west direction also will connect with this WSS port. And the signal in-out port will connect with our multiplexer. And we'll connect the transponder with filter. Now we receive the signal on the transponder, it goes to new WSS and based on the connection it will go to specific direction. We can send the signal into east, we can send the signal into west direction also. So now this configuration is directionless. Just making the cross connection, we can send the signal in any direction using one more WSS in our network. So I believe the concept of ROADM directionless is now clear. If you like the video, please like and subscribe. If you want to add any comments or feedback, please write in comment section. Also refer my blogs on www.opticstrans.com. Thanks for watching.